Well, there's no seed for honey, so the only way to ensure the honey supply is to protect the bees. But there's bad buzz going around the beekeeping industry in the United States now. Bees are simply disappearing. Animal Planet's Jared Miller looks into why.
Hey, Jared here, trying to avoid being stung by these Western honeybees. This is a very healthy hive of bees, but in late 2006, beekeepers like my buddy Bill here have discovered a very disturbing phenomenon. Entire colonies containing 40,000 or more bees completely and suddenly disappeared. This phenomenon is called colony collapse disorder. Unfortunately, there were no dead bee bodies left behind for autopsies. It affected 26 states, and some beekeepers lost almost half of their colonies. Scientists say that this bizarre phenomenon may be caused by human impact on the environment. Suppose you don't like honey. Whew, and no one likes being stung by bees. So why would you care if something was killing honeybees? Well, honeybees put every type of food on your table. American agriculture depends on honeybees to pollinate crops like apples, oranges, carrots, melons, celery, and even almonds. Some estimates say that one-third of every bite of food that we eat is made possible by honeybees. Honeybees are so critical to feeding all of us. That's why colony collapse disorder is so worrying. So what's causing this? So far, there are a lot of theories, many of which point to human impact on the environment. Let's look at some of these theories that experts are talking about. Basically, the earth is getting warmer, and that's a big problem for bees. To maintain a functioning hive, bees need to maintain a temperature of 95 degrees Fahrenheit. They do this through their body heat. If it starts getting too hot inside the hive, the bees start hanging out outside to cool down. So, a warming climate may make it difficult for bees to regulate the temperature inside the hive. This may be a reason why they're leaving the hives. Let's move on to some other theories. Mites, funguses, and viruses. Bees stink, but mites suck. Bee blood, that is. Mites about the size of pinheads can latch onto bees, weakening their immune system. Mites also eat bee larvae. Some bees are under attack by mites that are actually a conduit for viruses. Also in wetter climates, fungus is a factor. For a little over a decade, professional beekeepers like Bill have used antibiotics to help control bacteria, they've used antifungal products to control the fungus, and most importantly, have used pesticides to help control the mites which harbor viruses. To continuously protect their bees, some beekeepers have to switch around pesticides because mites are building up resistance to certain chemical agents. Some of these new chemical agents, unfortunately, may be contributing to colony collapse disorder. In the US, about 1,000 beekeepers raise bees organically, without the use of chemicals. And so far, no organic bee colony has experienced colony collapse disorder. Vast crop fields really aren't pollinated by bees that are just flying around in nature. Much of the work is done by colonies that are trucked in by beekeepers. You might think of honeybees as little insect migrant workers. Once they pollinate a field, they're actually trucked by the beekeepers to another job hundreds of miles away, and then so on and so on. The theory behind this is by moving the bees around too much or working them too hard might weaken their immune system. Plus, in their travels, they could be exposed to something that their immune systems can't handle. Again, for now these ideas are just theories, and they're still being discussed. One of these factors, or a combination of them, could be involved. No one really knows for sure, yet. But the mystery of colony collapse disorder is troubling. If we're doing something to impact the environment, which is impacting the honeybee, we're impacting ourselves, because the honeybee is what's putting a lot of food on our tables.
Up next, how far your food travels until it reaches you matters. We'll tell you why when Forecast Earth returns.